can't believe we're in fucking Colorado.
This is horrifying.
Fuck. Holy shit. Yeah, we did it.
This is like literally unreal.
We have so many people here, so we have to like kind of get to know everybody.
Everyone has good energy. Yeah, I kind of like them. I'm liking the vibes. I'm liking the people.
TLWL.
This is scary.
Oh,
real fast.
It really made me feel like I was in the middle of the COS challenge.
Honestly, I couldn't believe we were doing this. I was like, this is how TLWL
ends.
Everybody's been a little too buddy-buddy lately, so I see tensions getting high.
Say it to the person directly, like, there's no neutral that.
I'm trying to stay out of drama.
I don't do that. I don't play that shit nicely.
I'm gonna say, I'm pissed.
I never in a million years would I want to do.
You can't even provide an example.
As if for me, you're a fucking ungrateful bitch. That's what you are.
If everyone's complaining, you're the problem.
You sit there and run around this house talking about I have nothing in common with these people.
Bitch, do you want to get popped right now?
People are coming at me. I feel like I'm being attacked.
So I was
that's like, disrespectful. This is my first day here.
Oh my God.
You know me, I'm a little instigator, so I'm gonna start instigating a little bit.
I fucking told you I didn't fucking like her.
I don't like when you step over certain lines. Let's not sit here and lie. You're fucking jealous.
We both had the most beef with people in this house.
Agreed.
That's not how we vote in Jersey, baby girl. If you want to represent my state, you better get it together.
They can't handle
but
me.
What
that's
I miss.
The problem.
These people are just way too crazy for me.
Okay, yeah, you think I want that? Leave me alone. You're making it worse. I just want to be alone now.
Just be yourself. It's okay.
I would like to welcome you to a TLWL mini challenge.
Oh my God.
There's no sleeping in this house! Bartender!
This is the life we live. And I'm here for it.
TLWL Season 5!
I'm excited for this, but I am very, like, petrified right now. Like,
all the way down.
We're here! I'm trying to get the thing out of. Hi!
This shit looks so cool.
Yeah.
Alright, we're here.
We're here. They're spraying down our chairs. We're ready.
We're the first ones of the group.
First ones.
So, how are you feeling about this? Because I'm a little nervous. I'm not going to lie.
You're nervous? Yeah. I'm super ready. I love the adrenaline. I love heights. I'm with it. I'm down.
Okay, let's do this.
I'm ready.
Challenge
let's do
queen
this.
In the making.
Let's do this.
It was just so high. Honestly, I couldn't believe we were doing this. I was like, this is how TLWL ends. I was a little scared at first, but once you're in the air, honestly, it was just an amazing experience, and I'm glad I got to do that with Christina.
Oh my God, this is so amazing! Oh my God,
how fucking cool. This is beautiful, guys, you gotta experience this, it's beautiful!
I had a really good time ziplining with my boo Andres, you know. We hadn't really like been talking that much on the show because he'd be busy or whatever. So it was like a really cute moment me and him had or whatever.
Just don't even look down, just look straight. Look at this, it's so beautiful.
Oh my God.
We're going super fast, baby.
Oh my God, babe.
Lean back. It's all right. It's just that you're flying in the air.
I'm very scared. It's very pretty, but I'm very scared.
Yeah, very beautiful.
Oh, I don't feel secure.
Oh, shit.
Got the opportunity to zip line and we had to kind of pair up, and once again I kind of got paired up with Ava, and she looked at me and was like, okay, are you gonna protect me? And I'm like, okay, this is a step for us. Yes, we had our disagreements before, but us doing this together is showing that we can be in the same room, same time, and enjoy each other's company. So I think it was really good for us to zip line together.
You got this, Josh.
On the whole time.
I'm ready.
Make sure you hold it tight.
He's not doing it.
I'm so excited for you.
I'm not nervous.
Just make sure you hold on tight to it,
Josh. This is like a change in life experience for me, but let's see how it goes.
You'll be okay. Oh, fuck me.
Make sure it's on.
We're at Colorado Springs, bitches! Woo!
Believe it or not, I was terrified as hell. Like, I was very scared, and then me hearing everybody cheer me on actually made me excited and more happy because I thought I was gonna be like super alone, but I felt the encouragement. So it felt great going along the zip line.
I actually like this. Now I could jump on the plane. Like, I know I could do the plane now. Thank you, Dre Media. Go add him, you must add him. You gotta add him and subscribe to him because he's the best producer ever. Fucking Colorado, bitches! I don't know how I did this.
How was it?
It was amazing.
I don't know.
Oh, oh my god.
Yo, I'm so shoes.
So excited, though.
Yeah, I don't. My hands are really
sad. What the bonus is?
I want a piece of balls now.
I said, I thought I could beat the record. I feel like we're dressed up for the challenge, bro.
Right? Fuck! This is scary! Oh! Wait, guys, I'm scared!
We was going up these green stairs or whatever, and you know, my girl Janice went. Did I just say my girl? Anyways, so she went first, and she made that shit look like work. I'm not gonna lie. So, you know my ass had to go second and show them what's up.
Oh yeah.
Did I even do this?
Oh, yeah.
Oh
my god.
Oh! How do you even get? I don't care, I'm not trying to go the fast one.
Hey.
You got this, babe. Let's go.
Oh yeah.
Okay,
oh,
yeah. Let's go. Whoa. Yeah, good job. Oh my god.
I'm the only bitch wearing jeans.
I don't want to go back down.
Coco, yeah. Oh my god.
How do I put back in my phone?
Let's go, Asha.
Okay.
You just stand back up.
Okay.
I literally told Andres for the fucking longest, I'm not, mark my words, I'm not doing the caucus challenge. So you know what he said? He said, say less, sis. We're just gonna bring the caucus challenge to TLWL.
Let's go, Lance.
I'm like a big fan of like the challenge and obstacles and wanting to face my fears. I'm not really a guy that's scared of heights. And when one person does better than the next, you want to be better than that person. So of course when my turn comes up, I want to be the best of the best and kill it.
Come on, come on.
Chavo, you got this. Chavo, do it.
Step in the middle, hon. No, I'm thinking about that one. Oh, no,
come on, get it. There
you go. Let's go, Denise.
Jump. Jump.
I love doing stuff like that. Like, when I was younger, my dad would take me to like rock climbing places and all that stuff. So this is stuff that I enjoy, and it's not that I went there like cocky, like, yeah, I'm gonna get this done and be the best at it, but it was a little bit scarier than I thought. Everyone was at the bottom and they were like, keep going, like, you can do it. I didn't want to let anybody down, so I just kept on pushing, but that shit was scary.
My adrenaline! I enjoyed the job!
You have to!
Come on, you got it!
It's time!
Don't give up!
I did it! I can't!
Boom, bap, boom, bap! My adrenaline, baby! I thought I was gonna fall for dear life. I couldn't do half the shit.
You can do it! You can do it! Yes, sir! Strong legs! Strong legs.
Keep going, keep going.
Yes, sir. Come on, come on, come on. You got it, you got it. Yes, sir. Put those feet. Yeah. Another one. Another one!
Stand!
That was enough. I made my point.
I hate this! I'm gonna jump.
One more!
Oh my god!
There you go, there you go.
Middle circle, middle
mix.
Oh my god!
Man,
over there!
Oh, yeah. Take your dinner back! Yeah, you can, come on!
We got two more! We got two more!
Fuck me, fuck!
Hey, stand up! Stand up!
Stand
up!
Stand up!
Stand up! Stand up! Stand up!
Yes.
Okay. I love the ground, I really
good
do.
Job,
I'm little, so I got little legs. So that's like far for me. That's a big climb, you know? So I wanted to stand on it, but like I said, I'm little, that wind would have blown me away.
Oh yeah, last one! Last one! Stand up! Top one! Yes, sir! Ah, he's shaking! He's shaking!
I will never ever look at the challenge on MTV and say I could do that again in my life, because this should have been fucking easy and it's really not.
Good job! Again.
You did it!
Let's go, Ava!
No one's standing?
Holy shit! Come on, stand up!
Stand up!
Stand up! Stand up!
Jump!
Stand up! Stand up!
Holy shit!
Good job!
Thank you!
The stairs are definitely really intense. It doesn't look that bad, but once you're going up them, the last few are definitely really scary.
Almost there!
It just didn't cut it this time. I tried my best, but it was scary as heck.
That shit's scary. I was talking shit about everybody else.
What's your time call?
Let's go, Josh.
I thought of it as a challenge, so my aunts try to go as fast as I can, and I just wanted to prove myself out there because we play challenge games in this house, and clearly I was just a floater, so I needed to prove myself a little bit there, and I did.
Let's go, sit. Use your hands. Use your hands.
I'm nervous.
Yeah, keep going. You got this. You got it. Keep going, sit. You got it. Use your hands, mama.
No. Come on,
sit. Use your hands. Come on, mama. Yes, sit. You, sit, let's go, baby.
Sit, I can't.
Use your hands, yes.
Yes,
yes, crawl. Yes, sit.
I can't
do this. One more.
Come on, keep going, mama. Come on, sit. Yes, one more, sit. Come on. One more. Come on, Sid. No!
I'm a pussy. I don't know. It was just not my moment. It was just not it for me. I was not there for it. I did the zip lining and that was it. I was out. I was like, nope.
With Sid. With my partner. We both suck. Y'all the dead last losers.
We both suck.
Y'all the dead last losers.
Everyone else is gonna look so fucking athletic.
Oh!
Oh! You kissed it!
Oh my god!
Oh! Oh! Holy crap!
Nicely done.
Ava vs. Christina and JT vs. Leo. It is a plot twist. All right, who do you have your money on?
I have my money on Leo and Christina.
Sid, who do you have your money on?
Same.
All right, let's go.
Ooh.
Oh, snap. Oh, snap.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
Let's go, Leo. Leo. Oh. Let's go. Let's go. Oh. Let's go! Woo! You got it! The champ! The champ! Period. Anything to say, Leo?
This is why I never talk too much.
He's been beat me
before. I kill everybody. Period. Period.
They said I think I couldn't do what? I think I'm skinning the water.
I did not know what I was walking into. I did not know they was gonna have me doing no challenges, sweating my hair out. But baby, I had a real good time. And I'm up for the caucus challenge. See me there, bitch.
And how does it feel, John? You lost, man.
Still a beast. I'm still number one.
But today, guys, he was a number two.
Who won the challenge last night? Oh, you got eliminated, right?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Is this not? Like, are we not on like night three?
Okay.
That was night one?
Okay. Three.
We gotta get these guys.
Gotcha.
Yeah, Josh! Andreas! He can't hear anything, guys. Thriving. A king. A king! Andreas! What's up?
Don't even worry.
Do you think you're gonna redeem yourself?
It's not a race, but I'm still.
You think
one,
you're gonna obviously. Beat the obstacle course?
Yeah. Go for it.
If it was a race, we'll lose again.
Leo, that was so good.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I know.
What happened?
I'm a pussy. That's it. I'll admit it. It's just like my feet were just like.
Mine were sliding too. I was like, this
yeah.
Now that I epically failed on both the first obstacle courses, I'm versing Josh and Mike and Janice in a rock climbing contest, and hopefully I can pull out the win and prove myself, because that shit is all about balance and that.
But I went over the ledge.
I saw you.
Like a champ.
Ready, set, go. Okay. Mike already.
Okay.
Hey,
Andreas.
Okay,
yes.
Right?
Oh,
no.
Mike,
hook
it.
Huh? Hook. Good.
Go win.
One. Oh, Leo's fast. Oh, Leo, John, Mike, and Lance are still going.
No, she was literally on that one side
that was
for like entire time.
Let's go, Lance.
Okay.
Let's go, Lance.
Go, Lance.
Let's go, you're almost there.
Pat that bitch.
Let's go.
Nice.
Oh, okay.
Are you okay?
Nice.
Oh, okay. Are you okay?
I love how adventurous everything is this season because I'm very competitive with myself. So whether we're doing the rock climbing wall or we're doing like the relay races or the little challenges at night, like it definitely brings like the competition side out of me, which I absolutely love.
Final matchup. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, Mike won.
I didn't even try.
This entire day out has been amazing. We needed it as a group. I was just keeping my eyes open, scoping the newbies and even some of the OGs that haven't been on the Caucus Challenge. There's a lot of good faces that I would love to see cross over. I'm glad to see everybody smiling, laughing, making memories together, because as much as I love the drama and the tea, I also like to see us all having a good time. Just seeing everybody bond and get so competitive is amazing, and it makes me so excited for the future of Dre Media and the Caucus Challenge and TLWL.
We're gonna go to Walmart. Okay.
It's cold!
So based on the whole trip today and everything I've seen, I felt great. I actually spoke to more of the house guests. I got to know Ava a little bit more. I got to speak to Christina more, and that's why I needed it mainly, because it was pretty much divided. We were all divided, and I didn't have a chance to actually sit down and bond and talk to them or anybody as much as I did until today.
Easy, easy. There you go.
Oh my God, please slow down, Leo.
You're freaking everybody out.
But you're freaking me out. Freaking me out too. Hello.
I'm getting pretty pissed because, not for nothing, but I made it a point that I did not want to drive the whole time. Leo's the only one stepping up. Everybody keeps actually not even everybody the girls keep bitching about his driving, but I really don't see anyone like even remotely trying to step up and drive as well.
I just can't find the seatbelt right now.
I do not like when people complain, especially when you're grown. No one's offering up their time or license to go drive. So if you're not gonna volunteer as tribute, then don't say anything.
Nobody else wants to drive though. No. He likes driving,
so
let me drive.
I'm saying, because everyone has a problem. I don't fuck with you at all, because honestly, like, I have legit PTSD, and I thought I explained that already, and I thought it was mad disrespectful.
Leo is a horrible driver, and honestly, I did say that I vetoed him from being the designated driver, and I don't know why he was still operating the vehicle today. We almost plunged off a cliff. So I'm screaming at Leo because I have severe PTSD from a car accident that I got in a while ago, and I tried explaining that to him, and he's just so disrespectful about it, and he's ignoring everything I'm saying.
We're out here literally like risking everyone's lives on that turn, like not funny.
I was only going 10 miles per hour.
Okay, and it was way too fast.
I flipped in a car before. Literally, I'm not having this shit.
Exactly, like if everyone's complaining, you're the problem.
Whoa. I'm the problem.
No, you are, obviously, because almost every single person in this van
complained. Here's the Ava stop. You want to drive? You can drive.
I'll drive. All right, pull the fuck over.
I know they roasted me. I mean, it's typical. I mean, I get it. I mean, they're just scared, but I mean, I don't give a fuck. I mean, you can drive if you want, but... What's up, guys?
Yo,
what's up?
What's up?
Honestly, today has been pretty good. We did a lot today.
A lot.
Got cast pictures done. We explored.
I faced a lot of my fears.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm a little disappointed in myself, but it was really fun.
Yeah, at least you gave up. Like, you're the challenge guy, and you're the one
It's honestly way harder than it looks, but...
But honestly, I think today was really a good bonding experience for everyone. Like, we all spent a lot of time together.
Yeah.
And it helped us to, you know...
That's what we needed.
Got home. The rest of the group went to Walmart to get some stuff for tonight's little party.
And we're gonna fucking get drunk.
Hopefully everyone stay on their leveling and have a good ass
stay
time.
Stay on my level.
Yeah, okay, John.
I'm up there. Stay on my level.
Mister, I want to take a nap after this confessional. Today has been actually probably my favorite day here. Side note, I think everybody's been a little too buddy-buddy lately, so I see tensions getting high, and I guarantee something's gonna happen tonight.
And left home. John, I had some shit in my bathroom, and I left the bathroom door open, and when we came downstairs, the entire downstairs was like dick. Jump in, ho.
Smelt like dick.
Go off this.
Smelt like dick. I'm fucking shit in the bathroom, and left the fucking door open, and the fucking downstairs was like dick.
I sprayed your cologne like it. I was like,
oof.
Who's his or mine?
His.
Okay,
I cannot help you, baby boo. I'm sorry. Like, and the shit is already my fucking. I come home from a long day, because we were like out since like 10 a.m. It's like 9:30, so I'm tired. We went to the grocery store. We did a lot, you know. And I just wanted to like lay in my bed and relax. And I come down the stairs and it smelled like caca. Like, and I'm like, what the fuck? Like, why does it smell like that? So I'm like, maybe like, okay, like maybe something died in here. So like I'm looking around downstairs and I go in my room and it smells like ass.
Okay, I'm kind of getting a little annoyed because like when we're going shopping, I'm finding like the same people paying for stuff and then the same people saying they don't want to pay because they're not like eating this, doing this, but like,
why? Who did that?
The girls didn't want to pay for any of it. Because they only had a couple of things, but now they're like eating the ice cream that we bought. Or,
yeah.
Like they're gonna eat dinner that we bought. I just bought a bunch of alcohol.
Yeah.
Which I mean,
the only
like,
one
I
understand
care.
Kind
I
of
care
is like
share.
Ava, because she's not really eat anything.
And me too. Today, you know, you gotta take a shit. It's nature, right? So, I took a shit. There was no fucking toilet paper. So deadass, like I ran butt naked. Like I don't care if this airs, but I ran butt naked to get fucking tissue or something. And yeah, Asha wasn't happy because it stunk. And like, I'm not gonna apologize, I took a shit. We're all humans, you feel me?
My own brother cannot shit in my house. So, don't take it that personal.
I'm really not.
I mean, take it personal enough because like, it was you that did it.
Asha's first day here, she had it terrible. She had a 12 hour trip, so I understood her pain. She explained to me she doesn't like sleeping with people. So, you know, I was being a great friend. I thought so. So I let her, you know, sleep by herself. She wanted to chill, her own space. I gave it to her. I slept on a couch. I really don't give a fuck. A bed's a bed, you feel me?
God.
Took a shit, I mean, stuck up the house. I owned up to it. Like, there's nothing else I can do.
I'm really glad that you're owning up to it. All I ask for is an apology because I am attending.
I didn't kick Josh out of the room. Josh offered to stay somewhere else because I don't like, I don't know why Andres had me fucking staying in a room with Josh. I don't fucking get it. But like, Mike's just been sleeping in there, so I've been fine with it because that's like my boo. Like, you know, like we're close, so like I don't mind that. But like, he's like, I'm just letting you know I'm gonna sleep in the bed. No, you're not. You're not sleeping in a bed with me after you made the room smell like dick hole. We're not doing that.
I just think people need to kind of like just chip in and not be freeloaders. I don't know, it's just like kind of getting on my nerves a little bit and I'm getting irritated.
What's up?
Hi.
I need to make a confession.
Okay, by yourself or with us?
No, it doesn't matter. I want to evict Josh from the house because he took a shit in the bathroom, didn't close the door, and now downstairs smells like fucking dookie. That's dirty, dusty, and I blame this on you because you made me room with him.
But he doesn't even sleep in his room.
You haven't even let him sleep in the bed.
And he's planning on it tonight, and that's why I'm not sleeping in there, because there's no way that dookie smell gonna be sitting in the bed.
Well, then I guess
you're
gonna
be waking up smelling like dookie.
I told you earlier, everybody's been getting along for too long.
Wet wipes were
all right,
good.
Well, we're gonna see
sometimes
how
it's like wiping
goes.
A marker back there with the wet wipes.
I'm
just like,
wet wipes were good for you, booty.
Well, it seems like me and Lance are the two newbies and the two troublemakers, I guess, if you want to say. So I said, let me talk to him because I know from all the beef in the house, he had beef and I had beef. So I said, let me talk to him real quick and see how well he feels.
I don't know. I'm here to be cool, everybody. I'm tired of the fighting. I'm really not like this.
But I think we all learned it, like, as we get to know each other, to put those bygones behind. Because, like, me and Ava literally...
And it was the first day. We're stuck
Ava
here for...
Literally,
like I told you yesterday, you're gonna stop to see
each other. Yeah. Christina came and wanted to talk to me because me and her have definitely been two people that kind of had kind of the most arguments in the house with other house guests, something I would do is be the bigger person and try to have a one-on-one, no other house guests involved, to try to like iron it out and see where things go, because she really feel like her and Janice could have some type of like kinship, maybe if it's not a friendship, some kind of like sisterhood, because at the end of the day, we all are newbies.
You know what gets me? Like, I really didn't even get to know the girl. We didn't even say hello to each other for me to have like this beef with her. Like, so it is what it is. I'm down to get to know the girl. I don't fucking know. I get it. Some people be a little shy or whatever. So, and I'm the perfect person that will be opening up. So before that whole incident, I saw she was quiet, and I'm the type of person that if you're quiet, I'm gonna come talk to you, talk to you. So I was like, what's up with you? What's your name? What's your girl? Where's she from? Like, and I tried to have a conversation with her, but she was just really dry, very serious with me. Mm-hmm. So from the get, I felt like she did not like me, and she even low-key, she kind of said it herself. I don't like the way you walked up in here. Mm-hmm. From the second I opened that door, she did not like me, so.
You know, with us being newbies, we also came into it a little reserved.
I think we came in very strong.
We came in strong, but we also had, you know, came in knowing that, like, other people have these bonds, other, you know, connections. And I think when people come at us, we just attack.
Mm-hmm.
People get loud with us, we attack.
Thank you, because we're the newbies. Of course, they're going to try us. They're going to, like, you know, see how far they can get with us. And that's what I really felt, because I feel like they was testing me.
Yes, testing me.
And it was the day one. Why are you testing me?
Yeah, and, like, for me, I feel like after, like, further observation of my situation, especially my situation with Ava, like, you know, we had the little small one that first night, but that, I don't feel that was as extreme of what I had with Ava.
Of course.
And I feel like me and Ava kicked it off really early on, so it just, like, after further, like, evaluation, I realized that Ava is not a bad person. I also realized that I reacted a little too hot, but that's just because, you know, when I feel attacked, I attack even harder.
To be quite honest, I feel like Janice is really sweet. Like, I don't even know the girl. She seems like she's such a nice, sweet, quiet girl. I really don't know. If she my cup of tea, I don't know, but I'm down to be cool with the girl.
That's kind of how I feel like with me and Ava. I feel like we kicked it off really good on the first day. We was partners in the game. And then we had our little blow up. And I feel like some of the things I said in my blow up caused her to feel indifferent about me. And I'm from the South. Like, we're not taught to speak to women in that way. So after, like, further evaluation, I realized that, like, some of the things I said was a little harsh and was, you know, could have been said differently so that it wouldn't, like, necessarily hurt her feelings. But at the same time, I feel like by me saying that, since no one else would, it caused her to open up, because ever since then, she has definitely been more, you know, like, outgoing with everyone and really wanting to get to know them.
For sure.
But I do want to have a conversation with her. I have been trying to find the perfect opportunity for me and Ava to have our conversation. I want it to be a time where we're both in the right state of mind. I want it to be a time where we could both, like, lay out our feelings and really have that genuine one-on-one, because we have had good moments on this trip. We have been partners for many different parts of this trip, and I know Ava, deep down inside, is a really great person, and I want to get to know a little bit more about that. So hopefully that I could just, you know, stop being a little pussy and decide when I want to have this conversation. Just a real sit down.
Yeah, I want, like, a civil, genuine me and her. I don't want the whole group listening on and hyping shit up, because I want to be real. Like, there was no problem. Listen, the beef was not with the girl. Mm-hmm. It could have been any girl in this fucking room that was in my bed, laid up fucking. I would have went crazy on any other bitch.
Mm-hmm.
Do that in your bed. So it wasn't so much with her personally. It would have been the same way with any other girl in the house.
Yeah.
If they was fucking and sucking on my bed. Like, nobody would, like, that's disrespectful to me, don't you think?
Yeah, and that's how I feel. I think, like, you having a genuine conversation with no John involved, with no Ava involved, with no one in the group involved, and it possibly could get to a great resolution.
I think so, too. I'm with it, honestly. Do I regret what I did to her? No, I don't regret nothing, maybe. But do I think shit could be different? Of course. And would I like it to? Why not?
So it looks like we got some grown people pants to do today, some treason to do today, because my vocabulary a little off. I'm sorry.
It's all good, baby.
But, you know, we're gonna tree shit out and just be, you know what I'm saying?
Be the bigger people.
We're just gonna be the bigger people today.
Yep. So let's see how that all let's these see how grown, we do. Those grown people let's conversations see how grown turn out, baby.
Sorry.
Who
Who keep bothering us?
You know, Janice is a little shy. She might not come up to you and want to have that conversation, but if you, you know, that outgoing person like you are and want to be the bigger person, you go ahead and pull her to the side.
Next time on TLWL.
Try.
That's what I was getting my blend for.
Is that tequila?
Tequila is the enemy.
It's Christmas night.
It's Christmas night.
So I know the ho-ho-hos will be out.
Mike is so hot. Mike is so incredibly hot.
Get on the table.
Ooh. Oh, I like
when you have these. I don't know whose bright idea was to turn Colorado Springs into South Beach, Florida.
Yo, really I've never seen you get complaints in my life like this.
You came in here in hot boy shit.
You got your little Christina, Ava, you got them to back you up. I would shut them down too.
I can't lose business deals over a bitch who can't compete with me.
That is not what I came here for. I did not come here to start drama with anybody. I didn't come here to argue.
Okay, and you could feel disrespected.
She's packing, she's on the phone, talking to the whole wild nation, National Guard, talking about to get the whole army up in this bitch. I don't know what the hell's going on.